We all know distress reinkers are used to add color back to a pad that's been used often. But did you know that you can use them to make your own custom colored ink pads and distress ink sprays and use them with a brush to wash on color and with baby wipes? Well, you can, and we'll be exploring all of that today. Some of the time you know about a product, but you don't really know about it. You don't really think about it. You probably don't use it. And for me, that was the case with this cut and dry stamp pad felt. This is another product of Rangers. They sell it like they do the cut and dry foam applicator that you see me cut up and use with all kinds of things. But with this, you can make your own ink pads. Now you can make them very specific to a stamp in particular, or you can just make kind of a rainbow colored pad or a very random pad. And I'm going to show you both of those things. So it comes in this 9x12 sheet, or I'm sorry, 8x10 sheet. And when you look at it, you'll see I've already taken a chunk off of this. When you look at it, on one side there is this woven fabric, and on the other is this foam. This is the business side for us. This is the one that we're going to use to stamp on, and it's what we're going to use to apply the Distress Reinker. So I have three colors. I have Mowed Lawn, Tumbled Glass, and Bundled Sage. And I haven't had a chance to use these, but these are Dina Wakely's wonderful Scribble Birds unmounted stamps, or Scribbly Birds. So I'm just going to take one of these off of here, and I'm going to show you how I'm going to customize a pad specific to this stamp. First thing I'm going to do, I need to ink this with something that's not going to move. So for me, it's going to be Stazon. You could use Archival. You could use pretty much any ink that will not run once you add another liquid over it. So I need to ink up my stamp. This doesn't have to be a perfect image. This is just going to be a guideline for how you go ahead and apply the Distress Reinker. So this actually fits pretty nicely in here just like this. So I'm going to stamp down, make my impression on here. Then I'm going to take, I have some big scissors here. I'm just going to cut this off. So now I have my pad ready. What I have to do now is decide how I want to add the colors. So imagining this little bird, I can think about where I want the various greens and where I want the blue, or I can just kind of wing it and go for it. So I'm going to start with Bundled Sage. This is kind of the lighter of the colors. And again, I only need to put reinker where there is actually black ink on here from stamping with the Stazon. Now some of it will run into the whiter areas, but you don't have to deliberately ink that. Well, I guess I'm going to put some of this right here since that just dribbled on there. And you can see that this is going to absorb fairly quickly into the felt that's in there. Now the really cool thing is that if you store these in a zip top bag, something that's reasonably airtight or that is airtight, this is not going to dry out almost forever. I mean, you could use this pretty much endlessly. Lots and lots and lots of inkings in one of these when you go ahead and get this properly inked up. You can tell that I'm a very big fan of Tumbled Glass because there's not much left in this bottle. I know I have another one here someplace. So I think I'm going to bring in some of the Mowed Lawn now and add this brighter green. Now you could go for realism. Of course, birds are not necessarily these colorways, but you could go for realism if you wanted to. That's entirely up to you. Or you can just go fantasy and play. I think I'm going to give him a blue eye. I think that'll be fun. Maybe I'll bring the blue up to about, well, it's kind of made a mess there, so I guess it's going to come all the way up there. I wasn't quite as precise with the eyedropper as I should have been. All right, so this is nice and inked up now. Just put the, tighten the caps on these. Now, if you want to, you could stamp this on a piece of paper, make a chart, and outline. For example, I know that this is Bundled Sage down here. This is Mowed Lawn up here, and the rest is Tumbled Glass. You could kind of store this so that you have a notation and you don't actually have to count on your memory for what colors you actually put there. Alright, so this is just a piece of 90-pound watercolor paper. Now, working with a stamp like this, you really want a block that you can see through, because that way you can kind of line this up. And I'm just going to come in and tap this and ink it like I would any other stamp. And if I go ahead and give this a press, how cool is that? You get this wonderful multicolored bird. Now, I probably could do a little bit better job inking with the Bundled Sage, but you definitely get the idea of what I'm accomplishing here. I think that this is really, really cool. It's such a fun technique. allows you so much creative freedom. You can do so many fun, interesting things, and I'm a big fan of color. I think you probably know that, those of you that watch the videos with any regularity. I really do love color, and so an opportunity to play like this for me is just wonderful. It really allows me to get creative and think about how I want to do things. So here's my two birds. Now I do want to show you one other thing. Again, I've got to get a zip top bag to store this in, but you store this in that bag, you can re-ink it as you need to, and then you just use this over and over and over again. Now the nice thing is that this kind of polyester foamy stuff on the back acts as a bit of a non-skid thing, so this doesn't go slipping off the table on you, plus it stops the ink from bleeding all the way through, so you'll always have a clean surface on this side. Let me put that aside for 1 second and bring this in. Now you recognize this stamp. This is the Hero Arts Everything Flower stamp that I use a lot. I really, really like it. A few minutes ago, I did the same thing you saw me do just a second ago. I came in and I inked this with Stazon so I could see the image, and you can see it on here. And then I came in and I used various colors of Distress Reinker to go ahead and ink this pad. I used, let's see, Tumble Glass, Tattered Rose, Dried Marigold, Milled Lavender, and Picked Raspberry. So all I need to do is turn the stamp so it matches the orientation. Not that it matters, because this is so random that I can pretty much do anything I want here, but just so that you can see kind of what I had in mind. And I'm just going to go ahead, and you can see that non-stick thing is happening. I'm pushing really hard and this is not slipping off the table, so that's really nice. Let me just bring this in here. Go ahead and give this a good push so I get a nice impression. If you find you're not getting great impressions, put a couple more pieces of paper underneath this. Now, I didn't ink this as well as I could have, so it's not super dark, but how cool is this? You get this multicolor thing with absolutely no effort, and it produces really great results. This would be fabulous if you were making cards as a background on a card, and then you could put another piece of paper over the top. Now, you don't have to use this just for the stamp in particular that you inked it for. So I can bring in, this is just a script stamp, I can bring this in, do the same basic thing here. I'm just going to give this a good press so I ink this up. Go ahead and print this, and you'll see that I have multicolored text, which I think is really, really cool. How cool is that? You can do all of this really fun stuff, and the best thing is you just save this and reuse it over and over and over again. Spray inks of some sort are what I generally reach for when I want to add color to something quickly. They just work really well. I like the effects I get with them, and I'm going to guess it's probably the same for you. Whether it's color wash or dilutions, if I want some sparkle, I'm maybe looking for the Heidi Swap Color Shine sprays. I'm using Perfect Pearls, or I'm using Tattered Angels Glimmer Mists. Any or all of those. I'm either going to get just some color, or I'm going to get some glimmer mixed in with it. But of course, up until now, we haven't had any options for Distress sprays. I'm going to show you how you can make your own. Now, in the past, you've seen me make sprays that were in the small mini misters, and I incorporate some of the Distress Reinker for color and Perfect Pearls for glimmer. This is not what that is. We're just going to make some, in fact, some bigger bottles, because I want to be able to use this more frequently. So I'm going to make some larger bottles, and it's just going to be Distress color. There's not going to be anything else in there. This is the first batch that I made this morning. This was 1.5 ounces. These are 2-ounce bottles. So this was 1.5 ounces of just plain water, and I experimented, and I used 3 eyedropper fulls of the Tumble Glass Reinker. I like the color, but it's not quite dark enough. So what I'm going to do this time is I'm going to reduce the water. I'm going to use just 1 ounce of water, and I'm going to start off with, for Mowed Lawn, I'm going to start off with 3 full eyedroppers full. I want to see what this looks like. I think it's going to be a little bit darker, which it should be because I've reduced the water by 1/3. I just don't know if it's going to be too dark. So I just need to find a piece of scratch paper. Wrap one. I'm going to want to spray this, and then I'm going to mix up some Picked Raspberry, but first I want to see how this looks, because maybe I won't need 3 full eyedropper fulls with the Picked Raspberry. So I'm all sprayed up. Oh, this is great. I love this color. This looks really, really good. I think that's a good ratio. I think 1 ounce of water to 3 eyedropper fulls of the Distress Reinker works really well. So I'm going to do the same thing now with the Picked Raspberry, and you have to make sure you start off with a full eyedropper full of the color, so you'll want to squeeze that rubber bulb to make sure you empty whatever is in there, if it's in case it's only a partial, and then you get a full eyedropper full, and in we go. I mean, this couldn't possibly be any easier. You just need some empty bottles, a really nice mist sprayer. Go ahead and give it a swirl. And here's my color. This is great. Now I could actually make this a little bit darker if I wanted to, but I think that this works for now. So now I have the luxury of having distress colors in a spray form. Someplace here is a rag. I just want to wipe this up. And let's see what we can do in terms of making a background. So I've got mowed lawn, picked raspberry, and tumble glass. I'm going to start with tumble glass, and I'm just going to spray some on here. All right, I'm going to come in with the mowed lawn. Ooh, what a pretty color. And then I think I'm going to just add a little bit more of this. And then I'm going to come in with some picked raspberry. Just push this down so this doesn't run off onto the page underneath. Now, I could roll this, except I don't have a roll of paper towels down here. Somehow I managed to miss bringing one in, so I'm just going to use this rag to kind of blot this color up a little bit here in the center of the spread. And then it's just a question of bringing in my heated tool, and obviously I need to put some color back in here. I took a little bit too much out. I'll just bring in my heated craft tool, dry this off, and now I have a distressed background. And what I could do, if I wanted to, once I get this dry, is come back, turn the journal over, and then I can mop up the overspray with what's here so that I can get some real cool patterning on here. Obviously, that's an option as well, but at a minimum, oops, let me just mop this up because it's wanting to dribble onto the next page. But at a minimum, you can pretty much make any color of spray you want using the distress reinkers. And remember, there's 48 colors in the line, so you have 48 options for sprays. Before I move on to the next technique, I want to revisit this page spread that we worked on just a moment ago. I did what I said I was going to, or what I said you could do, which was once this was dry, I took this over, I turned this over, and I kind of placed it in the overspray that was on my nonstick craft sheet, and that's how you get this real cool patterning. And this is very obviously a sprayed background. You can pretty much tell by the way that this looks. It creates all this wonderful texture and patterning that is just fabulous. It's something that, you know, as I said, we all use spray so often. This is pretty much my go-to thing. But there are times when perhaps you want a little bit more muted background. I want to show you how you can get that. So I have milled lavender and tumble glass, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to slide this back. I'm going to put some of these colors both out on my nonstick craft sheet, and I'm going to use water to thin them again, but this time I'm not going to spray them. I'm going to apply them in very much like a watercolor wash effect. So here is my 1-inch mop brush. You see me use that all the time, and I'm just going to come in and I'm going to add some water to both of these colors. Now if I've thinned them out too much, I can always come back and add a little bit more. Since the milled lavender tends to be a little bit lighter color, I might need some more of that. And that's where I'm going to start. So I need to actually put some more water out here. My brush was dry, so I need to put some water in there so I kind of get that color loose and moving, and I think I'm going to put just a little bit more of the reinker in there. So now that I've got water on my brush, and I've got color here, what I'm going to do is just come in and just start gently laying this color down. Again, this is random. There isn't any pattern that I have in mind here. It's just a question of laying some color down. Now, I'm not going to run it all together. Because I'm going to pick up the blue, the tumble glass, with the same brush, I know that I'm going to end up changing the overall color of what's in my brush, so I want to put the lavender down where I know I want it to be, because I'm not, unless I wash this brush out, I'm not going to be able to come back and re-emphasize the lavender without contaminating it. So now I'm going to pick up the tumble glass, and again, I'm just going to lay color in here and there. And if I think this needs to be a little bit brighter, I can certainly do that. But the more of this I add, and if there's plenty of water on here and plenty of liquid on here, then I'm going to get some real movement of these colors, and you can limit that movement by not putting quite so much liquid on here. I'm going to need some more. I could have, in fact, wet this page to begin with before I even came in with the color, and that would have really promoted a lot of movement, but I didn't do that. It's just, there's always more than one way to skin a cat, as it were. So you can do lots of different things to get different kinds of effects. Now, I could miss this page if I wanted this color to really move, or I could just kind of leave it the way it is, and that way I know the colors are pretty much going to stay where they are. But this is basically done now. I can take a piece of paper towel, and I can just sop up the extra water that collects in this, in the seam there, excuse me, in the binding there. And I am going to just grab this that's kind of hanging off the edge of the page, because I don't want it to come down and get on the page that's underneath it. I'm going to kind of do the same thing here. And if I want to do a little addition by subtraction, I could come in and I could lift a little bit here and there. And if I come in with my heated tool and I dry this, then these color changes where I've lifted will actually pretty much stay. There'll definitely be some lighter areas. So I'll do that with the heat tool, and then I'll come back and I'll show you how you can take some of this extra color that's laying around here and we can do a little bit of spattering. With the background dry, you can see that these areas where I lifted with the paper towel are lighter, so you can create some cool patterning just by doing fun things like that. So what I want to do now is use a little bit of this color that's left on the table. I have a different brush because the mop brush is huge. It holds a lot of color and I don't want big spatters, I want smaller ones. So I'm just going to take a brush and now I'm just going to gently tap. There's color flying everywhere. And I'm just going to tap some color on here to create some spatters. If the background were wet, sorry, looking at my shirt to see how much I got on me, if the background were wet, this color would start to wick out, but because it's dry, the spots remain pretty much as they are. Now I've got some stuff left here on the table. I have some left on my brush. Who wants to waste? So bring in some rayon seam binding and just pat it in what you've got left on the table here. Take this and either let it dry or dry it with your heat tool, and now you have some colored seam binding too. So waste not, want not. We can use it all. The final technique for today is using the reinkers with baby wipes, and I'm going to show you how you can do a cool background and how you can color with them. So I have wild honey, and I have a couple of baby wipes here, and I'm going to use one color per baby wipe. If you wanted to mix them, you probably could, but I'm choosing not to do that. So I'm going to put a couple, because I'm going to cover a large area, I'm actually going to put a fair amount of the reinker on each of these. But before I, oops, I have it all over my hand. Before I actually apply this, I'm going to squish this around on my nonstick craft sheet. I want to kind of spread that color around so that I don't get one giant deep blot of color when I add this. Now, if you think that you've got too much color here, you can come in and just put a little bit of water on your craft sheet or your palette, whatever you're working on, and then you can thin that color out a little bit. Now, when I did this, where is this? Here, you can see that I've got some very deliberate marks. I did some circles. I've got some areas where I didn't get a lot of coverage, but what you do notice is that even though the colors are not permanent, there's kind of discrete layers, which I thought was really cool. So let's try this with the wild honey, and again, I'm just going to kind of use some different strokes. I'm not looking for full coverage. I like this kind of sketchy look that's not perfect. As you all know, I'm big on not perfect. It's much easier to achieve. So all I'm going to do is just kind of play a little bit here, and now I'm going to come in and I'm going to do the same thing with the picked raspberry. And if I think that this is a little bit too much color, I can go ahead and add some water, which I might do. I don't want to overwhelm the wild honey, which is a really pretty color. So here I come, and I'm just going to kind of stroke this color on. I think this makes really cool backgrounds. Very busy, because there's a lot going on. There's a lot of patterning and texture, but really, really cool. So this is certainly one way to use these with ink, excuse me, with the Distress Reinkers, is with baby wipes, making a cool background like this. And like I said, even though Distress is reactive, you get these really nice discrete layers, which I think looks really cool. So you get this really fun background. Now if I wanted to, I could dry this, come in with some gesso to provide a little bit of coverage and blot out some of this color. Then I could come back again and add some other layers, again, if I really wanted to. But for the sake of argument, I'm going to move on to the next thing. Before I go too far, I want to show you this. Now let me just quickly wipe this up. This is a background that I did ages ago, when I was demoing the De La Rani pearlescent inks. I had put some color on here, and then I came back with just either the silver or the white ink, and I put a coat of glimmer on here that really didn't change the color underneath, and then I spattered. And that's kind of what you see. I know you can see the glimmer in the spatters. But what I did, and this, I'm going to use the same baby wipe so I get the same look. I had some more wild honey on a baby wipe, and all I did was come in and just gently lay down some color. So you can kind of add to what you already have if you want, by stroking a little bit of color on like this. So your backgrounds don't have to be comprised solely of the Distress Reinker. You can use it along with something else like I've just done here. So that's something that you can do. Something else that you can do, and again, now I'm going to pick up the ones that I just had a moment ago. I can color with these. So I can take the Wild Honey and then I can come back with the Picked Raspberry and I can get some color on there like that. If I want to tap some color on so that I get a little bit of texture, I can do that. I can come in and I can color. This is from the Doodle Delight set. I always think of these as hats or stalks, and this is from Fanciful Florals. So the other thing that I can do someplace here, I have another one of the baby wipes. I'm just going to put a little bit of Mauve Lawn on there, just a drop, because I want to just do it on this bird. I want to come back. So we sort of started with a bird that was blue and green, and I want to show you a different version of that bird in blue and green. So here's a little bit of green, and I had I had a baby wipe that had tumbled glass on it, so I'll just grab another one. Grab some tumbled glass. Again, I don't need a ton because I'm just doing this little bird, but I'm going to kind of blend it out on my craft sheet so I don't get a harsh line of color. And now I can come in and I can just color my bird this way. Finish up my stalk here, my hat. So, you know, obviously the duh factor here is that you can re-ink all of your pads with the Distress Reinkers, but once you have them in your studio, you can do so much more with them, from images like this to the ones that we stamped a little earlier on, to backgrounds, to making your own sprays. This is just a really versatile product that I know you're going to use a lot.